resurrection. Did you feel it? It's lost its fresh scent. Now the wind comes from deep inside the forest, warm and thick. It billows in around us. These are dangerous times, but no one listens to an old woman. I went to the band office today to warn the chief. I tell him to postpone my grandchild's wedding. I tell him that the spirits are in the air and that the red moon is on its way. And do you know what he tells me? He says,
Lavinia, you should know by now I'm not swayed by irrational talk.
That's when it is $50 words. He says,
Lavinia, don't go around scaring people. You should be more responsible.
He says,
I'm tired of hearing about Indian medicine and New Age mumbo jumbo.
He says this to me, a fragile old woman.
That'll tear him a new asshole.
You know what he's doing, don't you?
Yes, he's lumping me in with that horse's ass, that white man living in the woods.
Brown moron.
I have lived for my people for longer than he's been on the earth. I helped them find peace when they laid the bottle aside. I have birthed and healed and guided each and every one of them. I have lived for my people, and that idiot chief cast aside my opinion.
Serena is my daughter and a more darling child no one could ask for. But her taste in men? She'd have been better off marrying a dog.
It's the way of the world. Women fall in love with fools because then they'll never be disappointed.
Curse him.
I'd love to. If I could, I'd curse him like no man has been cursed before. I'd curse him with bad skin, bad bowels, and menstrual cramps. But I can't. I love my daughter too much. Besides, everyone has one good quality, even Chief Chucklehead. He protects the forest. Even when the lumber companies are knocking down the door with their million-dollar promises, he holds firm. Lauren could have been one of those chiefs living on the hill with a big house and a fancy car front, but he refuses. Because of that, the forests and our medicines are safe.
Curse him anyway.
Mistress, I got the bottles that you asked for. You asked for them.
Good job.
You said, go into those woods and get them. So I went and I got them.
Good boy.
Yep, I did what you said. You said it and I did it.
I want you to pet him.
Of course. I would have walked with you. Old age, I didn't see it coming. It hit me in my behind.
You're getting so old now. Your face creaks when you smile.
I'm so old, I need a can of WD-40 just to get out of bed in the morning.
You're so old, you've been an old woman longer than you've been a woman.
You're so old. You're so old that... You're so old that you're old!
Thank you, Bob Hopeless. Lavinia, I'm not saying you're old, but I've known younger dirt. You're so old, I've seen corpses with more vitality. In fact, you're so old, death gave up on you!
Cat!
Tad.
Dog, did you see any spirits in the woods?
I smelled strange smells, and I saw strange sights, but when I ran towards them, there was nothing there, nothing there.
Must have been like taking a stroll inside your head.
Last night, I heard them singing, but I could only catch glimpses of them dancing between the trees. Spirits, and sprites, and little people. Called my name. But there's too much to do if I want to
fool had listened to me.
Maybe I'm being selfish. Maybe I should stay and watch over them.
And wait another 10 years?
50 years of healing bones and broken hearts you don't soon forget.
My people, I will miss them all.
And I will miss you both as well.
I'll miss you more, I'll miss you more.
Suck up!
You're perfectly welcome to come, but you're too independent.
Well,
and you, I can see, are longing for a little boy with lots of sticks.
Oh, a little boy, a little boy, a little boy!
I hope he beats you with them.
I know Cat will help you find him.
Since when?
You said you would.
You promised, you promised.
Was there catnip in the room at the time?
It's not here. Where is it? The red bottle!
Dog. Did you follow my instructions?
I went down the path you said, the narrow path, past the chokecherry bushes down towards the river. I went towards the river, but not in it. Did not play in the river. Then I went to the tree, the largest and thickest branches, the tree that only grows leaves on the west side. Then I went to the tree, I dug beneath it, and found a hole. I reached in the hole and found the bottles. Put the bottles carefully into the basket and carried them home. Carried them home.
But now think carefully. Did you see a red bottle smaller than all the rest?
I saw it, and I put it in the basket with my own two paws. I'm sure it's there. I'm sure, I'm sure.
Well, unless it's invisible, it ain't here.
Was it in the basket before you turned to leave?
Yes.
Did you come straight home?
Yes.
And did you turn your back even for a second?
They kept calling my name. Dog, they said, over here. And I pretended not to hear them, but then they called again. Dog, they said, over here. And I held fast. But then one whistled, and you know how excited I get. It's instinct.
This medicine was very important.
I failed you, I failed.
Oh, here's a stick you can beat him with.
Back up.
Bad dog.
I don't blame you. Spirits are wily. Mm-hmm. I chose carefully. It was the medicine I would have destroyed first. I should have gone myself if only I wasn't in such a rush.
Well, you know, it's like I always say. There ain't no fool like an old fool.
Mm-hmm. Hush, Cat, or else I'll turn you into a pair of slippers. What are they up to? I must warn my daughters. But first...
struck by light. lightning.
Can't you feel their eyes on us?
You believe in that stuff?
My cuckoo says that these woods are filled with spirits and little people.
She's the same cuckoo who talks to her pets.
She's eccentric. Should we call the hospital?
No signal.
Maybe we should drag him out to the road.
You grab his legs. I'll take the top.
Okay, I got him.
He's all yours. Enjoy.
Jerk. Don't be cheap now.
Too bad there weren't no deer out.
That would have been sick. Bringing down a big deer, showing it off at the wedding. Things would have been all over me.
Women go crazy over live animals, not dead ones.
Not like how it was back in the old days. Back then, a guy just had to kill something to get laid.
Now you gotta talk to them and be nice and all that crap.
If you're real nice, you don't have to talk at all.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Sex, right?
No wonder you never get any.
That'll change after I become MC Brown Powell with hype rhymes.
And no beats!
What are you laughing at?
What a stupid name.
You mean stupid good?
No! Stupid, stupid, stupid. We need something more cultural. Like DJ Bannock Soldier!
I can't be named after a food, not a starchy one. Girls will get the wrong idea like I'm fat or something.
Why don't you call yourself the Beaver Trap?
I like it. And now, live from the Regina Exhibition Center, MC Beaver Trap!
Show me some of your rhyming skills!
Alright, are you sure you're ready for this?
You're an idiot.
Live from the Collie Lake Woods, MC Beaver Trap. I'm big and I'm bad and I'm really glad to be here with my boy, whose name is Boy, and I'm slamming and I'm jamming and I'm big and I'm bad.
Wow. You suck.
Well, I've been so busy picking my name, I didn't have any time to spend writing songs. But now that I got my name, everything will fall into place.
A hit song, and I'll be drowning in beautiful women.
This will be so cool. We'll be surrounded by fine women.
No, you won't. You'll be married, remember?
Ah, shit! That's right! But what if I tell Kateri I'm your manager? Then she'll have to let me go on tour with you.
Do you know anything about managing?
About as much as you do about rapping.
Well, if you come out on the road with me, you have to behave yourself.
Who are you, my Kokum?
Boy, I know that you've cheated on Kateri a lot. I know all about you and Anita, and Bonita, and Renita.
And their cousin Danita?
I buy she is hot. But seriously, you're gonna be faithful to my cousin.
Dude! I love Kateri with all my heart. So, 90% sure, I'll be 80% faithful to her at least 60% of the time.
As long as you're sure. Holy shit, did you see that?
See what?
A little man running through the woods like this high.
A little what?
A little man with a face like a deranged hobbit.
Did you see a Keebler elf?
It was not a Keebler elf. Listen to me, there's something in these woods. Can't you sense it?
Dude. You really can't handle your weed.
Wait, look, I think I heard something.
What?
What is it?
Shh.
Is it an elf? Is it a little person?
Please let it be a good elf.
Ha! Mommy!
You should have seen your face.
Not funny. You really scared me.
What are you, a man or a little girl?
It won't matter if you're a man if those things get you. They'll turn you into a woman. Or something worse.
Just think, if you're a woman, you'd finally be able to touch some breasts.
Good one.
See, there's nothing to be scared of.
I ain't scared. I just don't want to be here when the spirit of the dead squaw rises again.
The spirit of the dead what?
You know, the girl from the legend.
You're talking about that old ghost story.
Before it was a ghost story, it was an old Indian legend, and before that it was true.
Ah.
A long time ago, before the white man came, there was this beautiful Indian chick.
How do you know she was beautiful?
Because all native people were beautiful back then. Man. Didn't you ever see Dances with Wolves? Anyway, it was hot. She had she's all like, I hope he comes. I hope he comes. But she's all impatient and shit. So this one night she decides to go swimming. And it turns out that this is the night he comes to see her. So he's in his canoe, paddling down the lake, and he hit her with the canoe.
No, dummy, that's not what happened. She was in love with him, and he hadn't visited her in a while, so she freaked out and killed herself. Typical chick behavior.
No, 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 she got hit by the canoe.
Canoe can't go that fast.
Maybe he was a champion paddler. Yeah. Or maybe she was a really fast swimmer. Mm-hmm. Or maybe it was a magical canoe, or maybe... Anyway, it doesn't make a difference. All I know is that she died, and now she's evil. And once every 10 years, she comes out of the water looking for her lost love. And if she finds the guy, she'll drag him back into the water with her. I wouldn't want to be that guy.
Hey, just think. Maybe she's evil and hot, like Taylor Swift.
You know how wrinkly she'd be after all those years in the water.
Well, that's the dumbest thing I ever heard.
What was that?
Maybe it was a rabbit?
Why are you walking away then?
What he wears, I'll remember.
What about him?
Let the evil squad trade him off.
He'll probably like it.
Great spirit, I'm confused. Was the thunderbolt a sign? What does it mean? Well, could you send me another sign to explain the first one? Wow! Thanks, Great Spirit! Thanks a lot!
Say
okay.
No, you say I do.
Okay.
Then
taking care of your daughter in the form she's been cultured to since she was domiciled under your roof.
What did he just say?
Boyd is saying that he's going to be the best possible husband that he can be.
That's what worries me.
Oh, Daddy, stop worrying.
Yeah, you give yourself a heart attack.
Straight up, Big V, and your health is prime official because you got to support the Red family.
Why are you talking like that?
Because I'm a rapper, MC Beaver Trap.
Dumbest idea I've heard out of you yet, and that's saying a lot.
But Uncle, it's for real this time.
Then sing me one of your rap songs.
I can't, everyone's looking at me.
Stick the boy in the grass.
Lord, you should be encouraging your nephew.
Where does he come up with these foolish ideas?
But it's his dream, then who are we to question it?
I'm not questioning his dream, I'm just telling him to get a new one.
But who always says dreams are the stars that guide our path?
Oprah?
And he gave a speech at the National Youth Conference last year that ended with, "Our youth are our greatest resource. Without them, we are lost." What inspiring words, Lauren.
Only because he helped write them.
I made a few suggestions. You put it all together.
Enough with the romantic crap already. We are here to rehearse a wedding. Let's keep on track, people.
Aren't we almost finished?
Not yet. Okay, so we finished with the vows. Next is the kiss.
My favorite part. Well, my second favorite.
No tongue, please. And then you head back down the aisle. Clap, clap, rice, rice, and we're done.
Then it's party down till our livers are brown.
Beaver, your liver's already brown. That's a natural color.
I know, because I like to party down.
Didn't you forget a part?
I doubt that very much. You see this checklist? It came with my internet minister diploma. I know what I'm doing.
What about the part where you say, does anyone have any reason why these two should not be joined in holy matrimony? Speak now or forever hold your peace? That's only a formality song, girl. But you're gonna say it, right?
Of course. Do we have to? It's so negative. Like as if someone's gonna say something.
Maybe. We don't want someone to say anything.
It's part of the ceremony, so it will be included. Okay, so that's it, everyone. Congratulations, thanks to your help and my careful planning and, of course, the checklist. I think this is going to be one smooth, trouble-free wedding. Mom!
Mom!
The wedding must be canceled! Are
you okay? You don't look so well. Have a seat. There's no time to rest.
What's that paint all over your face?
Protection from the spirits. The red moon has brought them out.
Oh boy, here we go.
The red moon has awoken the spirits and they are in the air making mischief. This time comes around only once every 10 years. I thought we had another week, but it has come early this year.
And apparently so has the crazy moon.
You think this is some kind of joke? I warned you yesterday at the band office. I told you to call off this wedding. You were putting my grandchild and the rest of these people in danger by ignoring my wedding.
No. I'm saving myself $20,000 by providing a wedding that my daughter wants. Of course, I would cancel it in an instant if I
Daddy.
Could. But I have lost hope of that ever happening. Thus, this wedding will proceed as I have planned.
As I have planned?
And I don't care if the seven plagues of Moses fall down upon us.
We are in a church!
But they see Cookham is straight up representing. Like, tonight me and Boyd were in the woods. We saw this little guy. And I was all like, whoa, look at that. And then we heard this crazy sound. We were like, maybe we should call the 5-0, but then we were like, no, better not, because then they would take our weed.
My head is killing me.
The wedding is off.
Wedding is on.
Up.
On.
Up.
On.
Up.
Off.
On.
I win.
You fool. I warned you, and this is the last warning you'll get. Proceed with this wedding and terrible things will happen, especially to you. And I will not be here to help you.
Where will you be, Mom? Mom, wait!
I'll get her. Her blood sugar's probably off the map.
Lauren, why didn't you tell me she warned you to cancel the wedding? We could have postponed it!
What for? Because there's some elves and fairies running through her garden? Because there's a unicorn nosing through her garbage? Christ's sake, Serena. Can't haul our lives every time someone comes spouting nonsense.
The red moon has given me a vision.
Why are you doing this?
This is really freaking me out.
Mr. Wisniewski, are you okay? Do you need a glass of water?
Mrs. Serena Starblanket, the most beautiful and compassionate. compassionate woman on the Calling Lake Reserve. I am so grateful for your continued kindness, and I'm so happy that we are to be family.
I couldn't find Mom. Hey, what's he doing here?
I have come to claim my bride.
Hey, Marlene, your old boyfriend wants you back.
Shut up, Lorne. What's going on, Jim?
I am called Eagle Flying High Above the Clouds. Now,
you know, if you're going to give yourself a new name, why don't you pick something simple like Village Idiot?
At least I have an Indian name.
So do I. It's no patience for assholes.
The Red Moon came to me in a vision and told me that I must take a bride, a young bride.
Funny thing about visions, eh? Always telling you things you want to hear, never something reasonable like, hey, why don't you grow up and buy some pens?
Who is the young bride?
Kateri Starblanket.
Who?
Me.
Hey, boy, here for your chick.
You're a dead man. Boy, the man's obviously deranged. Calm yourself down. Jim, get the hell out of here! Get the heck out of here before I kick you up! I told you yesterday at the band office you are not welcome on this reserve. You crazy wannabe Indian!
My great-great-great-grandfather was a Cherokee Indian. He led an ambush against the 7,000 soldiers.
He was at Custer's last stand.
He might have been.
No, he wasn't, because he doesn't exist. You've made up your entire knowledge of Indian history. These bones, they're made out of plastic. And that breechcloth was made in China.
It was not.
I can see the tag.
Look, I am not going to argue authenticity with you. I am in a deeper spiritual realm, and I must do as the spirits bid me. And they bid me to marry Kateri before the Red Moon has passed. That would mean in the next 48 hours.
Jim, Eagle, legs up high. Kateri is about to marry her boyfriend, Boy. So I think you might have misunderstood the spirits.
And honestly, Jim, is it really the spirits that want you to marry Kateri? Or is it the little spirit in your pants?
Yes, I am not marrying you. Not today, not tomorrow, nor any other day. I am about to become Mrs. Kateri Meatface, and no one is going to stop me.
I'm pregnant.
What? Exactly. When she came on to me, even though I knew it was wrong, I
couldn't resist.
Why not?
Because I was drunk.
Oh, that is so lame.
Kajiri, what else could it be? How could anyone in his or her right mind choose someone like her over someone like you? You're the most beautiful girl in the Calling Lake Res.
Beautiful like a model?
Beautifler. Says so.
What else do they say?
They say Kateri's like an angel that got thrown out of heaven for being just too damn hot. People are always asking me, hey boy, how's someone like you end up with someone like her?
What do you say?
I tell them the truth. I got lucky.
You really say that?
Cross my heart, stick a finger in my eye.
I want to believe you, but I feel like if I let you talk your way out of this, then we'll be starting a whole pattern of negative behaviors that can continue for the rest of our relationship. I've seen this one episode of Dr. Phil, and there's this woman who ignored her husband's affairs, and it only got worse. And Dr. Phil is like, it's important to really pay attention to the other person and be aware of their pain. So, we would need at least a month of counseling to get to the root of this selfishness. Not that.
Get off of him, you tramp!
I'm saving his life.
How?
By rubbing your breasts in his face?
You're such a bitch.
Slut.
Fat ass.
You're fat.
No, you're fat.
How dare you speak like that to a woman I love?
What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Because I love you.
Boy, I'm over here.
I know.
Wait, is
this for real? Oh, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Claire's gonna explode with love for you.
I can't breathe. Ugh.
Boyd, stop joking around. Come over here.
No.
I mean it. Come here.
No.
Boyd, this isn't funny.
Nobody's laughing. That is the laugh of true love.
He doesn't love you. He said so in the church. Don't you remember that?
Why did you say that?
I don't know.
Because she's a skank.
Maybe so. But she's my skank now.
That's the sweetest thing a guy's ever said to me.
What are you doing? We're getting married tomorrow.
Do we have to?
Boy, you love me. Not even 2 minutes ago, you were telling me how much you love me. Don't you remember that?
Oh, yeah. I remember.
See?
I was lying.
Cousin.
What was she wearing again? Ballet flats, skinny jeans, and a pink blouse that really brought out the highlights in her auburn hair. Or something like that.
Well, here are some tracks, Boyd. Wes, it looks like there are three of them. Boy, these girls have huge feet.
Those are our tracks. We've been going in circles.
Perhaps I can be of some assistance.
I doubt that.
Well, from my studies of Red Feather's collected works of Indian customs and cultural practices, first thing to do is to check the area for broken twigs. Such as this one. See? See? How it is broken. Facing the east.
That's west.
I know it. West. Now I look below the tree, and I find a shoe print of a woman of about 150 pounds, with a graceful walk and flashing dark eyes.
Wow, you can tell all that from a broken twig? Mm. You're a regular tonto PI.
Thank you. You got lucky.
Oh, no, no. I've been living in these woods for 6 months. They're a part of me now.
Have you ever seen any spirits in these woods?
I have, from time to time, felt the presence of spirits.
I knew it. What about an evil squaw?
Everything you need to know about spirits is this. If you leave them alone, they'll leave you alone.
It's not what the elders say.
Am I older than you?
Yeah.
I'm your elder. See, they'll leave you alone. Keep checking.
That is the gross oversimplification of Aboriginal spirituality.
It's coming from a man who prays to a dream catcher.
At least I know how to make one.
I don't have to prove anything to you. I'm the chief of this reserve. I'm a descendant from a long line of chiefs.
As am I.
I was born and raised on this reserve. I was taught my culture.
Which you have failed to pass on. And in fact, spend most of your time denigrating those that practice it.
Not true.
Oh, no? Who destroyed, who ordered the sweat lodge destroyed?
The sweat lodge was destroyed.
Yeah, yeah, and who ordered that destroyed, huh?
Well, you built it wrong.
Right, well, what about the youth cultural camp? Who canceled the funding for that?
Bunch of kids sitting around listening to old stories, they would have hated it.
I want to hear the old story.
You see? Your own people are starving for their culture, and yet you cut them off every way that you can. Why?
Why is a white guy wearing a fake buckskin breechcloth, which is too short, by the way, telling me how to lead my people?
Because somebody has to.
It won't be you.
You stubborn old man.
Crazy white man.
I think I hear something.
Dingle boy!
Don't you?
Boyd.
Oh, hey, Mr. Starblanket. What are you doing out here?
Looking for my daughter, your bride.
Oh, she's around somewhere.
You don't know where she is?
She was around before, but she kept yakking too much, so we took off. Isn't that right, honey? Let's come here and give your Pooh Bear some honey.
Beaver! Go get a large stick. Just squaw. I better do it.
I can do it, Uncle. I know how to get a stick.
No! Screw it up!
So does this display of semi-erotic tickling mean that the wedding is off?
Oh. What do you want, son? Because I want whatever you want.
I
want
to be with you.
Aww.
Oh, there you are.
Kateri, I've been looking all over for you.
Well, you found me. So, I've been looking for you for the past 2 hours.
We were hiding from you.
Oh, that's funny. That's very funny. I just found this whole situation so funny.
Hey, I like your style, young lady.
Shut up. So... very happy for you.
For real?
Yes, I can be the bigger person.
Well, you are fatter.
Thanks for letting me know that. So, to celebrate this turn of events, I would like to propose a toast to the two of you. May true love last forever.
You go first, my love.
No, not her!
What are you doing?
Why do you care?
Because I'm your Pooh Bear.
But Terry, darling, why don't we go somewhere where we can be alone?
Oh, why would we want to do that?
What's this whispering? I'm hearing whispering.
I wasn't whispering. So you want to go someplace?
Oh boy, am I tired. Oh, I think I'll go home. I'll come too.
Me too.
She never said you.
Never said you either.
Love that.
Doesn't the girl die in her poem? That's too sad for a wedding.
Serena, it's not a love poem unless
Marlene, I've been thinking.
And I can't believe Kateri wanted a dessert buffet. I mean, does she want her diabetic relatives to kill themselves? And don't get me started on the open bar.
Maybe we should cancel the wedding?
What? Have you lost your mind?
Or at least considered the possibility of possibly canceling it?
No one is canceling the wedding. Not after all the work I put into it.
Marlene, calm down.
I am calm. The wedding is going to happen. The wedding is going to happen.
You know, sometimes weddings are better done when it's simple, like when Lorne and I got married. Oops. Will you look at that? I dropped a stitch.
What were you going to say?
I can't remember. Oh, look, I dropped another one. I'm such a Butterfingers today. Butterfingers, isn't that a strange name for a candy bar?
Serena, you can talk about your wedding. I'm not going to freak out.
I know, but I don't want to.
I've had 19 years to adjust, of course. 5 of those were spent under a doctor's care.
I was up for some tea.
I know I've had my relapses. Like that time I broke all the windows on your car.
Accidents happen.
Or that time I released cockroaches into your kitchen.
Water under the bridge.
Or that time I shot at your house.
That was you.
But my point is, I healed.
That's great. Okay, so that's that.
Serena, I forgive you for stealing my boyfriend and eloping with him. I forgive you, little sister.
You're hurting my hands.
Sorry.
It all worked out for the best anyway. I mean, you've got your own love now, right? That guy you met on the internet. How's that going?
We broke up.
What happened?
Well, I asked him to come to the wedding, you know, so we could meet the family and, well, me. But he didn't answer me. So I messaged him on Facebook. I sent message after message. I poked him. I sent him invites to relationship counseling support groups. I DM'd him on Instagram. I even emailed him. Maybe I scared him off.
I hope he's okay.
Me too. I really love him, Serena. The same way that you knew Lauren was the one for you. Well, that's how I feel about Mac Computer Lover 114.
Greetings, fair maidens.
Oh! Jim, breech cloth alert.
Oh.
Where's Kateri and Boyd?
Don't worry, the whole idiot caravan's on its way.
More than just friends, Mrs. Starblanket. We're soulmates.
That's nice, sweet.
We are not soulmates. Stop touching my hair.
Excellent. Everything is going according to plan. One bride, check. One maid of honor, check. One father of the bride, check. Mother, check. Minister, check. Best man, check. Weird white guy, not on the list, but what are you gonna do? Check. Okay, we're ready to roll, folks.
Where's the groom?
This damn checklist?
Picking flowers in the field.
For the wedding?
At this point, I wouldn't assume anything. He's acting kind of strange, even for him. Personally, I think it's drugs.
Oh, you! It's nothing more than the wedding jitters. So, I'm glad that you and Song Girl cleared up the whole, you know, lying about your boyfriend situation.
Oh, I wasn't lying.
You are pregnant?
No, I lied about that.
That's nice.
Mrs. Starblanket, I love your daughter, and I would never do anything to hurt her. Again.
Oh, I distinctly said no more hugs. This is my space. Respect my space.
She loves me. She loves me.
There you are, my honey queen.
Ew, are you trying to kill me?
If you died, I would die right along with you.
Boy, are you okay? You look dehydrated. Marlene, can you get
you some juice.
Way to invite yourself to juice, Eagle Guy.
How about I help you with that?
We had trains.
No, I'm gonna help, please. Please let me help.
Stop begging. It reminds me too much of our relationship.
I hate this dress. Leave it alone. This wedding dress will take you away from me.
Girls, please stop fighting over a $2,000 dress.
I can't let them take you away from me.
So, girl, I swear, I'm this close to
Are you threatening my beloved with violence?
Boy, she doesn't love you. Ask her.
Do you love me?
No.
How can you not love me? Everybody's loved me ever since I was 10 years old.
It's true. This guy gets more tail than a trapper. What? Not in church.
If you let go of this dress, I will let you hug me. No more than 30 seconds, no squeezing, and keep your face out of my face.
Can I braid your hair later?
We'll see. Kateri. What's going on?
Nothing.
Why are some kind of boy acting so strange?
I don't know. It's not my fault.
Why are you being so defensive?
I'm not. You are.
Okay, everyone, some clear, delicious lemonade to help restore the spirits. Serena, Song Girl, Boyd, Bieber, and Kateri. Oh, no, I think you want this glass, a special one.
I don't care.
Don't be rude, Kateri.
But this is a special glass, and you were the bride, so you should have the special glass.
I pay for this damn wedding.
No.
I'll pay.
No, no, Lord, don't. What the hell are you doing? Sorry, get off the trip.
Trouble of none. Well, more nap time.
He's here.
Oh, my hair. Look how bad I thought. Do you think he'll notice? He won't be able to pick me up and swing me around. Cat, look at me. Look deep into my eyes. Do you see me? Do you see a young Lavinia, 17 years old, at a round dance with a silly walk and a silly smile and skin soft as a baby colt? Can you see her?
Oh, I see her.
Lavinia.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Are you crazy? I've been waiting for 10 years and you're keeping me waiting again?
Hello, Henry.
What is that?
It's a new dress. Do you like it?
Yes, but that's not what I meant. Why are you covering your face?
It's cold.
Your face is tougher than leather.
How dare you? Did you come back from the dead just to insult me? Because I won't stand for it.
Lavinia, let me see your face.
No.
I know you've aged, Lavinia.
I don't want to be old today.
The earth is old. He's still lovely.
My face is like leather.
That's because he never shied away from tough times. Remember that time? Coming from the big bush, the horses lost their way. We had to get out of that wagon and walk leading them through that blizzard. All the way home, the wind whipped our skin. I was so tired. I was ready to give up, but there you were right beside me. Your skin all rosy and chapped.
I was so foolish.
I never saw such a beautiful woman in my life. Can I see her again, please? There she is, the most beautiful woman in the Capel Valley.
Oh, go on.
Lavinia, come here.
Meow.
Thank you. ever noticed the way he's always grinning? He looks like an ape. I don't know why any woman would ever want him.
You did.
Yeah, but I didn't really want him.
Then why did you sleep with him?
Hey! Let's sing a song! Papa, don't preach.
Answer me!
I don't want to hurt your feelings anymore.
I need to know.
Can I put my head in your lap?
Song girl?
You're just gonna get mad at me.
I won't get mad.
Can I tell you a story first?
No, answer my question.
Please, please, please let me tell you a story first.
Why?
Because it's important.
Fine.
Okay, it's the story of the first time we met, me and you. My mom and I moved back to the reserve when I was 8, and school had already started when we got here. So I knew all the kids would be friends already. I walked out into the playground, and sure enough, everyone was paired up in 2s, and 4s, and 6s. There didn't seem to be any room for another girl. I walked over to some Indian girls. They said they didn't play with poor girls. I walked over to some white girls. They said they didn't play with Indian girls. I walked over to the boys, and they told me they didn't play with girls. So I went to the swings by myself. As I sat there on the swing, I wondered if this school would be like all the rest. I never had any friends at those schools either. I always came too late. I wondered what it would be like if I never made any friends. Then I saw this girl come running out of the school with long, dark hair and a pretty dress. Everyone wanted to be her friend. The white girls stopped to talk to her. The boys ran up to her and teased her. The Indian girls crowded around her. When I saw her, I said a special prayer to the Creator. I said if I could have one friend, any friend in the whole world, I wanted to be that girl.
So what happened?
You threw a rock at me.
I did not.
You did. You nailed me right in the head and I fell off the swing and everything. But it was okay, because you came up to me and you said you were sorry. And we became friends, and we've been friends ever since.
We were. You slept with my fiancé. A friend doesn't do that.
I'm sorry.
No, sorry doesn't cut it. I need to know why.
I slept with Boyd because, well, because I was jealous of you.
Why?
Because you have everything. Everyone loves you and you have nice hair and the best clothes and a nice family. Everything always works out for you, and that's not fair. So I began to think, how can I hurt Kateri? And then I was like, hello, sleep with her boyfriend. I mean, it's so simple. What's the sense of being a slut if you can't use it to your advantage? Do you want to make out?
Get away from me!
But you said you wouldn't get mad!
How can I not be mad? Well, the person I thought was my best friend is actually my worst enemy.
I could never be your enemy. I love you too much for that.
You don't love me. Not for real. Underneath this spell, you hate me, and you always have.
I could never hate you.
Get away from me. I can't stand to look at you.
I'm sorry, Kateri.
Go away. Farther. So far away that I can't see your evil face anymore, because it upsets me.
Songer! I've been looking for you everywhere. In the weeds, in the houses, at the band hall, in the arena, and in the sidewalks, and in the ditches, and
we
the roads.
We get it! Let me go!
No, you're just gonna leave me again.
I can still see you, song girl.
I'm trying to go. Let me go. I have to get out of Kateri's sight.
Why?
Because she's mean.
You're mean.
I forgive you for saying that, because I know you're not yourself right now. But I promise you I will break this spell and free you from this trap.
I am free. Free from you.
You don't mean that.
No, I do.
No, you don't, Boyd. Come here.
No!
Listen to Kateri.
What do you want?
Look into my eyes and tell me, what do you see?
Brown, white, red face. There's some gook in the corner of your eye.
Look deeper.
What am I looking for?
For our love.
What does it look like? Because I'm not seeing anything.
Kiss me. Go ahead.
What did you feel?
Kind of freaked out. I mean, my girlfriend's standing right over there.
Don't you remember being in love with me?
Let's see. Well, I remember I liked hanging at your guys' house.
You had the best TV on the res.
But what about being with me? Didn't that make you happy?
I don't know. You're bossy, you yell a lot, and I had to compliment you at least once a day. That was annoying. The set was all right.
You jerk!
See what I mean about the yelling?
I can't believe this. My dad was right. I literally can't believe this. You ass, why didn't you tell her that?
What? Was I supposed to lie to her? You should have told me that first.
Too aggressive. What do you think?
Uncle, he's a dude.
You know what he is. It's just one letter from one man to another. A letter of mutual respect.
You have an attractive head. That's a come on. This guy's gonna think you're into him. That's what I would think if I got this letter.
Son, you are a homophobe. That's right. I blame that rap music. Lost touch of your culture.
All I know is it sounds like you want to make out with him.
Long ago, two men could love one another and no one would say anything about it. In fact, it was understood that this friendship would strengthen and stretch these two men.
I bet it did.
You don't get it, do you? No man is an island. Everyone, even your chief, needs a peer or colleague that they can depend on to bounce ideas off of, to cheer you on, to make you fly higher than you ever did before.
What about Auntie Serena?
Oh yeah, women are great, understand, blah, blah, blah. But a male friendship can give you a little bit extra. You can be yourself around another man.
Like in the locker room when we have parting contest?
Exactly.
Or like when we watch pornos and talk about sex with easy girls.
Right.
Or like when we throw gasoline on the fire and try to jump over it.
Stupid, but yes. So you understand then, you're all uncles and gay. He's just interested in a deep and rewarding friendship with another man.
Yeah, I understand.
Good. Tell me what you think of this poem I wrote for him. It's called The Legend of the Lonely White Man.
Lauren, could I talk to you for a minute?
Of course, of course. Please sit. Get your ass up. Sit anywhere you like. You can have my seat if you want.
No, that's okay. Are you feeling all right?
Feeling wonderful. Mm-hmm. How do you feel it? Mm-hmm. Are you cold? I could turn up the heat.
No, that's okay.
Up too warm then.
No, I'm okay.
I could turn on the air conditioner.
That's fine.
Are you hungry? We have food. Beaver, go get some food for Eagle Among the Clouds.
Above the clouds.
Right, exactly. Beaver, go.
Okay.
kind of food?
Any kind. He's a big head.
I've come to you with a proposal.
Wasn't expecting this. I mean, I felt it. I didn't know if you felt it. What are we going to do about my wife?
A business proposal.
Oh. Right. Come to the right place. I am the chief. All business flows through me. I'm a very powerful man.
I want to cut down the forest and harvest it for drug research.
The whole forest?
Yeah, the whole forest.
What kind of drugs are you going to make?
Well, this and that.
What's the bad I'm going to get in return?
10%.
Net or gross?
Net. So, is that okay?
I can't believe you have the audacity to come into this office and offer to destroy the entire reserve, natural resources, in exchange for a pittance!
Well, it was worth a shot.
Hey, just kidding. Of course you can. You have a deal.
Really? Wow, that's great!
You have such a pretty smile.
You know, Lauren, I'm not sure if the reserve will agree with the terms of this deal.
Of course they will. I'm the chief. They do what I say.
Right. Right. But... yeah, this is such an unusual deal that I wouldn't want anything to screw it up.
Right. What do you think we should do?
I have a great idea.
Sure, you have a lot of great ideas in that attractive head of yours.
And I cannot live without you.
There we go! I'll fix!
next?
I can't accept a proposal like that. I'm not an idiot.
I told you it wasn't going to work.
What kind of mean trick was that?
It wasn't a trick. I was trying to make you happy.
I know a way we can all be happy. Wouldn't be a god if I didn't at least try.
Bad. Very bad.
What's wrong? Is it Lord?
Chief.
Whitey. Meeting.
The chief and Jim had a meeting?
They forest money.
They forested money?
The chief is letting Jim cut down the forest for money.
Yes.
You're very good.
Thank you, eHarmony.com.
Dad sold the forest to Jim. Can he do that?
No, he cannot.
And here come Dumb and Dumber now.
I have something going out.
Beaver just told us you sold the forest to Jim?
As usual. Beaver's got it all wrong. I've only leased it to him for 1,000 years.
What?
Hey, it's for a good cause. It's gonna harvest drugs from the forest.
Drugs? Oh, what kind of drugs?
That's a ridiculous idea!
Hey, let's at least hear him out. Listen, people. There are thousands of drugs in that forest that can help all of mankind. Drugs that could heal the common cold. Drugs that could help asthma sufferers. Drugs that could make your wildest desires come true.
The forest is more important than money!
Well, to be honest, I was more interested in the drug research, but then Lorne came up with the idea of selling the lumber. Yeah.
This is our chance to pull ourselves out of poverty and to defeat the oppression of the white man!
Whatever is in that forest is the property of the band! It is not for your profit!
By the band, you mean the members.
Exactly!
Like me.
You can't be! You're white!
I adopted him as my son. Now he's an Indian just like us. Hey, isn't that great?
Wait, you're an Indian now? That's right, Beaver. I'm just as Indian as you are. I mean, sure, I may not have brown hair or darker skin or be discriminated against or subjected to racist stereotypes, but inside here, where it matters, all Indian.
Lawrence! You're not right in the head. Someone has drugged you.
Oh, and next I suppose you're going to say the chief did it.
You are the chief!
Nope.
Yes, you are. You're the elected chief.
Guess again.
Okay, chief.
Bingo! We have a winner here. I appointed Jim interim chief, which is permissible under band regulations, should the chief be indisposed or fatigued or...
Insane?
It's only in the interim, you know, until the contract has expired.
For 1,000 years?
Or however long it takes to make a significant profit out of our natural resources and cultural knowledge. Right?
Eagle eyes in the sky? That's right. Wyandotte, we need to make sure no one leaves the reserve. We need to keep them together.
But Cookham is gone. She's not coming back.
She'll come back. It's only a matter of convincing her.
But how will you do that?
We don't have time to explain. Trust us.
You can't leave me with these crazy people.
You need to be strong. We need you to watch over the reserve.
Yeah, and make sure that eagle, what's his name, doesn't start cutting it down.
But how do I do that?
Remember when I always told you to use your head and not your beauty to get what you wanted?
You want me to sleep with him?
Ew. Oh, God, no! He's disgusting!
Have you seen his feet? Have you smelled him? He's like a walking outhouse.
He wants an home.
You know, this is my ex-boyfriend you're talking about.
Then you know what we mean.
Kateri, you obsession to your advantage.
I don't know, Mom. I don't know if I love the reserve that much.
The future of this reserve depends on your beautiful face.
I knew I was born pretty for a reason.
And feminism just took a giant step backwards.
Serena, the eagle's hungry. Can you make him something to eat?
No, I'm doing something very important right now.
But can't you cook first and then do whatever you're going to do?
Lauren, honey, and I say this with as much love as I can muster, go to hell!
Ooh.
She's in a mood.
Hey, must be on her moon time.
Strange, women complain about PMS, but really it's the only time they can be themselves.
You know what's really strange? That you have a name like Beaver, considering you never get any.
Oh, nice.
Have you there. So, Kateri, I hear that the wedding's been called off due to your boyfriend's extracurricular activities.
So, what's it to you?
So, if you like, as the new chief, I could get Boyd kicked off the reserve.
You could even have him killed.
I can do that?
Obviously.
Visit the construction company that's gonna tear down the reserve. You wanna come?
Eagle's gonna show me how to use one of those big shrimp hooks.
I thought you'd love the land, but now you wanna rip it apart.
Well, I'm gonna make this reserve billions of dollars.
That's impressive.
If you cut down those trees, I will hate you forever.
Well, yeah, you say that now, but you wait until the money starts to roll in. When I start to shower you with jewels and gifts. Tell me, what's your favorite kind of car?
I'm not materialistic.
I'm partial to Cadillacs.
Oh, come on! Every girl has that dream car. That car that she imagines herself in when she's driving down the highway. Her hair flipping in the breeze. And while she's driving, people whip their heads in her direction and they say, who is that girl? Who is that beautiful girl driving that
Mercedes XL1 convertible with a beige leather interior and diamond studded rims?
Oh. Don't be ashamed, Kateri. It's only human nature's desire.
It's natural.
Stop throwing yourself at it.
Kateri, you look pale. Are you okay? Do you need a massage?
No.
Okay, a small one.
Okay, now that the gang's all here, let's go cut down some trees.
Uncle, that's not a good idea. Beaver, you have to understand that change is good. Change can open us up to new ideas. Change can lead us in new directions. Change can make us stronger.
Hear, hear!
Not all change is good. Destroying the forest will not make us stronger because it will weaken our resource base.
Right.
How did you know that?
Remember, I slept with that tree planter last summer.
No! Chief is right. He's more than just a man with an unusually attractive head, you know? You should listen to him. It makes a lot of sense. But I understand your fear, because I used to be resistant to change, too.
Please don't say you're gay. Please don't say you're gay.
Eagle, you know when you told me that I was starving the people culturally? You were right. I have been doing that.
Yeah, well, now you know.
I have a reason. I never told anyone this before. But my great-grandfather was the medicine man. He saw this world change from tents and teepees to houses. He saw the people give up their horses for cars. He saw the church people rush in. He saw the kids being sent off to residential schools. He saw great hunters become farmers. He saw it, and he didn't like it. So when it came time for him to train my grandfather to pass on the teachings, he refused. He said, it will never be what it was. When we buried him, we buried 1,000 years of songs and medicines and stories. I guess that's why I am the way I am, out of respect. But I'm thinking now, looking at this forest, I won't hold back anymore. As I think if my great-grandfather could see what I see, those trees standing over there, if that forest has managed to stand up against everything and grow stronger, then maybe our spirituality could be like a tree. We cannot resist change, but we can grow stronger in the face of it.
That's powerful, Lorne. Now let's go cut down those trees.
Remember the red moon.
What?
You're supposed to marry me, right? Before the red moon is done.
Are you proposing marriage?
Yes.
You little hussy! I knew you wanted him all along!
Go kill!
Kateri, what are you doing?
Song girl, stay out of this.
But do you love him?
She'll grow to love me. Right, Kateri?
Not before the wedding.
Right, okay, all right, whatever you say, then let's go and get married.
First, I have to change into my wedding gown.
Well, I'll help you.
No! I mean, I'll meet you at the church.
Oh. I'll be there.
Eagle! What are you doing? Didn't our time together mean anything at all?
Lord! I don't love you that way. I love you like the way that you love Beaver.
Hey, don't bring me into this.
I love you the way that
It's complicated.
No! It's very simple. I love you. I'll do whatever it takes to make you love me.
Well, unless you can become Kateri, I don't think there's anything that you can do.
Well, that's that.
Beaver, there are two kinds of love in this world. The first is that weak kind of love that fades after a few months of, who opened that window? Who's turned us into new dishes? Who forgot to flush that toilet? And there's that other kind of love. That's the kind of love that can transform you, that can move mountains, the kind that can continue from beyond the grave. Guess which one I feel for, eagle who flies high. Guess!
Second one.
I have a plan that will make him mine forever. Now, come with me! I need your help!
Not even pretending to the French anymore, are you?
No, it's the wrong thing.
Of course you'd say that. You're not thinking straight. You're not yourself. You're the one who's not herself. The Kateri I know would never marry somebody she didn't love.
What's so great about love?
I love Boyd, and look how that turned out.
What did it feel like?
What?
Your love for Boyd, what did it feel like?
It felt like love. Like how it's supposed to feel. I don't know. You can't describe it.
Love! It's like releasing a balloon into the air. It feels good, but you don't know why.
You can't remember it or you can't describe it.
Love is different things to different people. And my love for Boyd just happened to be the unexplainable kind.
When I haven't spoken to you in a few hours, I start thinking of things to tell you. I make lists in my mind. I think about how I'll tell you and you'll smile at this and laugh at that. And when it's something really great, like when I won those AC/DC concert tickets, I can barely hold it in. I pace around my bedroom waiting for you to answer your phone because it's not special until I've told you.
Somerville, I have to do this. I promised my mom. But I would really appreciate your support. Boy, I need your help too. I want you to go to the church and offer to preside over the wedding.
I'm not a minister.
That's right. So the wedding won't be legal.
Then why do you want me to do it?
Boy, go!
Thank you.
quiet.
You really think we should?
Desperate times call for desperate measures.
You know better than to ask questions like that. If the spirit wanted you to know, it would have said,
Hey, Marlene, come over here. I've got something to tell you.
Right away, Marlene. I've been watching you. You've been spending a lot of time on that internet looking at pictures of men.
Hey, those sites just pop up. I have no control over them.
I want you to spend your time looking around you. Life passes by in an instant. You don't want to waste it looking at a box.
It's actually a flat screen, but I get what you mean, Dad.
Marrying your former fiance.
No, it's cool.
Wonder what's taking her so long. What if she changed her mind? What if she's not coming? Oh, boy, do you think that she's coming?
A lot of people get killed in this Bible, eh?
They're hearing. I don't know.
You didn't get here yet.
I haven't seen her.
Boy, what are you doing here?
I'm doing the ceremony.
Why?
Well, he offered to do it.
And he's paying me. Even got me an official internet certificate.
Yeah, when it comes to the important moments in my life, I don't like anything left to chance.
That's why you're the chief.
I'll go check on your bride.
Okay, she's ready.
She is? I will go to her. Let me go to her. I will welcome her to the next stage of our life together.
No, you stay where you are. I'll get her. Boy, cue the music. Wait. Stop. Jim, Eagle, Flying, whatever the hell your name is. Siri wants to be married traditional.
Well, we are in a church.
I mean like Indian traditional. And in the Indian way, the groom cannot see the bride until the ceremony is completed.
Why?
Stop asking questions. This is what she wants. You don't want to piss her off, do you?
No. Okay. So I keep my eyes closed until when?
Until I tell you to open them.
Well, of course, Jim. I can hardly wait to become Miss Eagle, whatever your name is.
sure, cuz? Eternity's a long time.
Of course I'm sure. I got this all under control.
Your funeral?
No, it is her wedding.
And may I say, by the way, young lady, you are the most beautiful bride I've ever seen. Simply breathtaking.
Stop! I never want to hear another compliment as long as I live.
So, dearly beloved, we are gathered here again to join this white man and this young girl in legal matrimony. Do you, Jim, Eagle Guy, take this woman?
Yes, yes, I do, yes.
I am Jim!
Don't listen to him, please, Jim.
I'll never love you like I love you, Jim!
Oh, that's so dignity.
What do you know, Beaver? Have you ever been in love? Have you ever had a girlfriend?
No, but even I know that you can't make someone love you. The best you can do is be yourself and hope that they choose you.
I already tried that. It didn't work.
Then that's your answer.
Carry on. Boy!
I prefer father boy. Okay, where was I? Kateri, do you take this white guy to be your husband? To have and to hold to death, do you part? Okay, listen to me. I'm talking about death now.
I do.
And do you, Jim, take Kateri?
We already did that part.
Okay, okay. Okay! Ashes to ashes.
To say I pronounce you man and wife.
Stop rushing me. Just give me a job and go and do it right. Now, does anyone have any reasons why these two should not be joined in legal matrimony?
Not only do I object, but I would gladly take Kateri's place. You do that for me?
But I don't want to marry her.
Thank you, Songgirl, but I gave my word. Father Boyd, you may continue.
What about my objections? I have a right to be married! So, by the power vested in me by this Bible here, which is a pretty scary book, by the way, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Get your greasy lips away from my granddaughter! Which ones?
I'm too pretty to die!
Make a difference now, but I'm sorry I wasn't a better friend.
I forgive you.
I'm ready now.
Wait!
into a deeper understanding.
Lauren?
What are you doing here?
I came to talk.
You're not going to spray me, are you?
I'm here.
You want to talk about?
How's your frog?
Eagle Flies High is doing just fine. No thanks to your mother. Really, that woman should be reined in. Eagle thinks so too.
Looking out onto this lake reminds me of a story I heard of a long time ago.
There's lots of stories about lakes.
But there's one just about the Capel Lake.
You mean that ghost story that the kids tell?
It was a love story before it was a ghost story.
You know, Eagle and I are kind of tired. I have a long, busy day planned tomorrow. I have to build a shelter, find them insects to eat, protect them from real eagles. I need my rest.
It's a short story.
I'll try not to fall asleep.
A long time ago, when it was just our people who lived on this land, two young people met a gathering in the valley and fell in love.
Just like that, they fell in love.
They had known each other their entire lives and had loved one another from afar. Finally, the time had come when they were old enough to marry. They made plans to be together that summer. Their family lived in the valley. Their camp was on the shore of the lake. She said, "When you arrive, I'll be the first to greet you at the lake's edge. And when the summer is over, I'll leave with you to be your wife."
Something bad happens. I can feel it.
Hush! So he traveled to the valley, and he brought his canoe. He paddled day and night.
Sounds like he was in a rush.
Then one night, he knew he would reach the shore by morning, so he decided he would rest his eyes a bit. He leaned back into his canoe and had not rested even a second before he heard his name. He sat up and said, "Who calls?" No one answered.
Maybe it was a bird.
He thought so too. He made excuses even though he knew what he heard. The voice called again. This time he sat straight up and yelled, "Who calls?" But no one answered. And he knew they never would, because the voice had come from too near, as if inside a dream.
And then?
He made his way to their camp on the shore's edge, and she was not there to greet him. Her mother led him to where they laid her body. Her mother said, "She called for you twice last night, a moment before she died, and he was too late."
I don't like this story.
It's our story, Lauren.
That's nonsense. That would mean that you and I, that we...
knew each other in another life.
I don't believe in stuff like that.
Lauren, you're in love with the frog.
Stop throwing that in my face.
You know the first one that we met?
Vaguely.
Marlene had brought you home from university. You look so cute, sitting at the table, looking so nervous as my dad asked you questions.
Your dad never liked me.
I was nervous too.
You? Why?
Because I knew I would do anything to be with you. I love you, Lauren. I've always loved you, and no spell will ever change that.
You're a very nice woman. But as you can see, I'm kind of spoken for.
I hope everything works out for you, too.
Maybe I could come by sometime. You know, to visit. Or maybe I could check up on Kateri. Did you know that she tried to steal Jim away from me?
I'm sure she had reasons.
Water under the bridge. So, I'll see you around sometime?
All right, then.
Just what? So you really believe that story?
Yes, I do.
And you think I'm your soulmate?
I know you are.
But if it were true, wouldn't I feel it too?
I think that's how it works.
Maybe you have me mistaken for someone else. That happens sometimes.
Maybe. I should get back to the house. It's getting cold up here.
Oh, wait. You want my coat?
What will you use?
I'll be fine.
I guess I'll see you later.
Okay. Hey, do you want some company on the walk back? The woods can be kind of scary sometimes.
Okay.
Ego, I'm gonna walk Serena home, okay? But don't worry, I'll be right back. That's strange.
What's wrong?
He said goodbye.
Kateri! What are you doing?
The wedding is canceled.
Why?
Because I don't love you, and you don't love me.
Of course I love you.
No, you don't, boy. You really don't.
Kateri, you're the most beautiful girl on the calling
list. Don't even try it.
Well, you know what? I'm never getting married.
All of womankind just took a collective sigh of relief.
Men aren't supposed to get married. It's unnatural. We're supposed to be free to spread our seed. Isn't that right, Beaver?
I don't get to spread mine very often.
Don't you see, Beaver? We're free. We can sleep with anyone we want, anytime we want, however we want.
Boy, life is not like Tinder. At least not for me. I think I'd like to get married someday.
Way to go, cuz.
Then, you know, someone would have to have sex with me.
That's no reason to get married.
What other reason could there be?
Because you love the other person?
That takes so long. You have to meet the girl and then be nice to her and talk to her and buy her a ring. That could take like a year.
In the meantime, you can get a job and a haircut. Start working out. Buy some decent clothes. Learn to wipe your ass.
Being is too much work.
I hope I never see another wedding again. I'm so sick of flowers, of cakes, of dresses, of invitations. I'm even sick of rice. I hate love.
I guess so.
I hate everything about it. Someday you'll find your true love. Someday you'll fall in love. Someday, someday, someday. Well, what if someday never comes?
What if you spent your life wishing for something that never existed in the first place? What if it's all been a big lie to get your hopes up, and we're all just a bunch of suckers? That's right. Give up on ever finding love, or else you'll spend your life chasing after a wisp of smoke. You'll run, and you'll run, and just when you finally grasp it, you'll open your hands and find it was nothing after all.
That was kind of a downer.
Is this where the wedding is taking place?
The wedding has been canceled.
Oh, well, that's great. Thanks, God.
Well, you don't have to be that excited.
Sorry. It's just that the woman that's getting married, well, I'm in love with her.
Excuse me? Wow, you're such a magnet for her.
Isn't she a bit young for you?
No. The woman that I'm talking about is 35 years old. I met her over the internet.
Oh my God, he's talking about your auntie.
He can't be. Auntie Marlene is 40.
Shut up, Kateri. What's your name?
Mac Computer Lover 114. Or Ruben, if you want to get technical.
Ruben! I tried contacting you all week.
Why didn't you reply?
Are you... You're hot Indian chick!
Whoa! Talk about all that discussion.
My name is Marlene.
Well... You said that you were getting married, so I came all the way from Florida to stop it.
No, I said there's a wedding. Come if you want.
No. You said... Yeah. Come to my wedding. Mm-hmm. It will be lots of fun. You can meet my family and friends. Why would you call it my wedding if it's not your wedding?
Well, it sort of was mine. Hmm? I planned it.
Oh, I like the colors.
That's the same blue as the classic Microsoft Windows background.
I recognize it. So you're not getting married?
No, no. Oh. So, you drove all this way for me?
Yep.
Shouldn't you guys, like, kiss? At least give her a hug.
Oh,
a hug.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
So, are you enjoying the weather?
It's been a little stormy, but other than that, it's been fairly mild. So, how was the drive up?
Oh my God, old people are so stale.
Oh, where are they running off to?
You know young people, always in a rush.
So, you get wireless out here? Or?
This is so boring, my ears are bleeding.
I've been to funerals out here.
No one is forcing you idiots to stay! So, what operating system are you running on these days?
Some people call me old school, but I still prefer OS X.
Oh.
Nice. Excuse me for a second, Ruben. Fever!
Don't hit me.
What do I do? I'm dying out here.
Well, you like him, don't you?
Of course.
Then go over there and tell him.
No, you can't do that. You gotta play it calm, cool, collected. Make him think you don't like him.
But how will that help?
Then you'll be in control.
Love's not about control. Follow your heart.
Don't listen to him. He's a virgin.
But I'm scared.
I think you're supposed to be.
Ruben, you must be very thirsty after your trip.
Oh. Kateri!
Now that you mention it.
Wait, Ruben. Before you drink that, answer me one question. What kind of car do you drive?
Tesla.
Drink up.
I don't want to go.
It's not far.
No, Lavinia.
my chin and make those funny noises you make after you eat too much that make me laugh, that make me laugh.
Remember, I'm an old woman. It's not like we can forget. It's written all over your face.
Besides, as you get older, I can help you. I can do errands for you, carry messages, fetch things. Fetch things? I can fetch things.
That's true. You are a great help to me.
If I leave you, who's going to take care of you? The cat?
Again, it will come for me when it is time. Well, good, because